short stories. Have you had the chance to read a short story before?
No.
If you've read a short story before, please raise your hand. Okay, well, like two or three of you. If you have read a novel before, please raise your hand. Okay, a few more. So let's start by talking about novels, and then we can move into short stories. When you read a novel, what do you pay attention to? What do you focus on? Character. Who are these people? How do they feel? How do they think? What are they going through? Okay, what else?
Plot.
Plot is what is happening. Well, not exactly. I'll get back to that. But plot usually means what is happening. What is going on? What else? Time. Okay, can you say a bit more? Do you mean the time of the story or the time spent reading, like, for the story to take place? Which one? Okay, so like how long it takes for the story to unfold. Let's call that pacing. Pace is 步调步伐, like how fast you want. So pacing is the idea of how long it takes for the story to develop. Okay, good. What else? Conversation. Okay, let's call that dialogue. Even though it's usually, or it can be more than two people. So what the characters are talking about, and also how they talk. Okay, what else do we pay attention to?
The word building and the background of the story.
Okay, so do you mean like setting? The world of the story, right?
还是录完好了，稍微稍微好了。
Okay, so setting, when you translate it into Chinese, it makes so much sense. So the world of the story, the time and place where it happens. But also more than just the time and place, there's a reason that we call it world. Because if you look at a time and a place, and you look at the kind of people in the story, it can sort of come together and create a world. So if, like, the author suddenly adds a new character, you can immediately feel whether this character belongs or does not belong. Right? It's not just a time and a place, and it's an entire world, and it has its own kind of logic. Right? So, like, if somebody in Harry Potter came to Hogwarts with a computer, you would feel very weird about it because it doesn't fit the world. Even though there are computers in, they're technically supposed to be computers in the world of Harry Potter. Technically, but you never see one. And there's a reason for that. It doesn't fit the world. What else would make it? Any other ideas? How about symbolism, Shangzi? What does that mean? If you took Chinese in high school in Taiwan, Shangzi, these two words may still be a bit confusing for you. The basic idea is I say something and I mean it in one way, but I also have a lot of different meanings I want to tell you. So if I say, like, I'm really bad at coming up with examples, why did I do this? If I say that I care a lot about helping you understand literature and passing the course, on the first level, that means I want to help you, I don't want to fail you, those ideas. On the second level, it means that I think literature is important for some reason. I think it's important for you. And I think that it's more important for you to understand and pass than it is for me to demonstrate my authority as a teacher by failing you or, you know, taking credit away from you for some reason. There's always more than one level. Sometimes it can be very obvious, like if you read a poem, some poems only make sense when you think about the symbolism. Some of the essays we will read or stories will also have very dense or thick symbolism. But in order for it to be an essay or a prose work, the literal level, not the symbolic level, but the literal level should still make sense. But we can always pay attention to the symbolism. Okay, did you think of something else we can pay attention to? How about, let's put it here. How about the language? So independent of who is, I probably should have moved this around. Independent of who is saying what, the way that the essay tells you something, not just what it says, but how it says it, what words does it use? What is the order of the sentences? How long are the sentences? The language that it uses could also be a key part of understanding the essay. And then one last thing. The theme. The theme is the main idea. This is what I hope you will be thinking about when you read each essay. Story, I'm introducing stories. When you read each story. Even though stories are often like fun or entertaining, there's always some kind of idea behind the story. There's a reason why characters do things and say things. And often, because stories come from a single author, most of the time, what the characters believe, what is important in the world or society in the story, most of the time fit together. And that fitting together can be explored as its theme or its main idea. So a good story usually is not written to express a theme as its purpose. Usually a good story is written to, you know, to entertain you, to make you feel, to make you think. But usually, the best stories also have a clear theme to help you understand or help you feel what it wants to convey. So that's also something you can pay attention to. Now, let's move on to short stories. What's the biggest difference between a novel and a short story? It's short. So, how might that affect these different elements? Instead of 300 pages, you're reading 13 or 30. The biggest difference is probably in the pacing, right? How much information, how much story can you fit into 30 or 13 pages? So in a novel, like especially in a really long novel, often scenes will take page after page, people will talk about seemingly unimportant things, they will walk around doing nothing. But in a short story, there's not enough space for that. So supposedly, in a short story, every sentence matters. Hopefully you're reading novels in which every sentence matters anyways, but in a short story, every sentence really matters. So even if it seems like something boring or something that's very simple, we can always think more about why that's in the story. Instead of, like, if in a short story it says, this character went to close the door. Usually, if it's not important, we can just assume that that person has closed the door. The story doesn't have to tell you. So if it tells you, there's probably some kind of symbolism in the act of closing the door. What could that be symbolic of? Closing a door. Shutting oneself in or out, depending on where you are. Separating oneself from other people. If you walk into a meeting with your professor and your professor says, close the door, you know something bad is going to happen to your grade. Things like that. So there's always another kind of meaning, especially in a short form like the short story. setting are probably the most important parts. So if a story says it was a sunny day, good for walking, then you can assume that like the wind is not too strong, it doesn't turn rainy later, the ground is not wet. Like, very simple, clear ideas. But also, if the story says something strange about the setting or about the world, like suddenly a cloud appeared, then you know it's not just a cloud that passes by. There's meaning behind the cloud. There's a reason the story includes that. And we can think about how the idea that each sentence is important changes how we look at all of these, like character. One of my favorite examples of a really short character is, so Taylor Swift has a song where she sings, "I'm made a rebel of a careless man's careful daughter." And I'll just say it again, "I'm made a rebel of a careless man's careful daughter." You immediately understand this person. What kind of family they grew up in, what kind of father she had, what kind of person she became, and what meeting this dude has done to her. Very short, but you get the full character. Not every short story is as good as a Taylor Swift song, but hopefully we can also see concise but deep meaning in the way that characters are presented in a short story as well. Now, as I said, short stories are short. So it's not easy to fit everything into one short story. Often, stories will focus on like two or three of these, and the others will be sort of undeveloped or flat or treated less importantly. And you can tell that sometimes, for instance, the dialogue is not as important as what the characters feel and think about the events of the story. Or sometimes the setting is not as important as what the characters do and say. So for each story, we can think about the balance between these elements. Okay, do you have questions about short fiction, short stories? Okay, next week, we're going to read Hills Like White Elephants by Ernest Hemingway. Have you guys read Hemingway before? Maybe like The Old Man and the Sea? No? Okay, so the thing you need to know about Hemingway is his short stories are really short. Like really, really short. I think the file I uploaded is 3 pages. But as we have just discussed, since it's a very short story, we can assume that every sentence carries a lot of meaning and weight. For Hemingway, that's even more important to remember because he has a principle of writing he calls the iceberg principle. And the idea is, for Hemingway, you need to do like a complete preparation for the story. You need to understand the characters and what's going on and all the meanings. But when you write it down, you should only have to write down the tip of the iceberg. And you can leave the rest for the reader to find out.